Good day to you from Chem Help ASAP. Even through the 1990s, the stated holy grail of organic chemistry was to create larger molecules through the synthesis of new carbon-carbon bonds. We've seen ways to do this, namely with organometallic additions to carbonyls and even reactions of acetylides, but the SN2 alkylation of enolates, the topic of this video, is one of the most common methods for making new carbon-carbon bonds. Any reaction that uses an enolate will start with the formation of the enolate. Our first step, number one, will be deprotonation of an alpha proton of a ketone with our strong base LDA. So here is our alpha carbon, and there are hydrogens. LDA, we'll just write B minus, removes a proton to give the enolate. With LDA, this step will always be its own numbered step. Note that the solvent is normally an ether, often THF, tetrahydrofuran. The enolate is an intermediate. I tend to think of the enolate as a carbanion because that's how it will normally react. Your instructor may favor the other resonance form of the enolate, which has an O minus. I admit this is the major contributor according to the rules of evaluating resonance forms. Either way, the enolate is an intermediate. Once formed, the second step will occur. Number two, step two. We will have an alkyl halide added to the reaction. The enolate will attack the halide at the carbon, kick out the leaving group. This is an SN2 reaction, and we will form a new chain-extended ketone. This is an SN2 reaction. The enolate is certainly a good nucleophile, but it is just a good nucleophile, not a great nucleophile. Enolates are fairly basic and can also perform an E2 reaction on the halide. Therefore, in enolate alkylations, the halide needs to be a primary halide. So our halide must be primary. Hindered halides, like secondary halides, will undergo an E2 reaction. The net effect of this reaction is extension of the carbon chain on the ketone. I have shown in this top reaction that our ketone is a cyclic ketone. The ketone does not need to have a ring. If we started with a simple ketone, like acetone, we could do the same conversion. Step one, LDA. Step two, a primary halide. And we would still get an alkylated ketone. The key idea is that we have introduced a new alkyl group from our alkyl halide onto the alpha carbon of our ketone. We have made a new carbon-carbon bond.